This video is going to be about solving inequalities. And basically, solving inequalities is no harder than solving regular equations. Let's take a look at one. So here we have 2x plus 3 is less than 9. Now, if this was just a regular equation, the first thing I would do would be to subtract the 3 from both sides. So I'm going to do that. On the left side, I'm just going to have 2x. I still have the inequality sign. 2x is less than, and then 9 minus 3 is 6. Once again, thinking if this was a regular equation, I would divide both sides by 2. So I'll do that next. On the left side, I've got an x, I've got my less than sign, and I've got a 3. So the solution to that inequality is just going to be x is less than 3. Now, if I'm told to show this on a number line, I may be told that I have to show my answer graphically. I'll draw my number line, show where 0 is, show where the 3 is also. Since x doesn't equal 3, I know that I want an open circle at the 3. And if x is less than 3, that means x could be 2 or 1 or 0, anything to the left of the 3. So I'm going to darken all that part that's to the left of 3. And I'll draw an arrow to show that I keep going that way, all the way to negative infinity. And this will be the graphic representation of my answer. And this will be the symbolic representation, or the algebraic representation. X is less than 3. Okay, now, there is one place we have to be careful. And we can see that in this problem. So here I have 4 is less than 3x is less than 4 minus 3x is less than negative 2. So once again, I'm thinking I want to get the 3x, the x by itself. I'll start by getting rid of the 4 on the left side. So I'll subtract 4 from both sides. Subtract 4 from both sides. That's going to give me negative 3x on the left. I've still got my less than sign. And negative 2 minus 4 is negative 6. Now, what I would want to do is get rid of this negative 3, so I'm thinking I should probably divide both sides by negative 3. Here's the thing to remember. When dealing with inequalities, anytime you multiply or divide by a negative number, the inequality sign changes direction. So let's see what happens. I'm going to divide here by negative 3. I'm going to divide over here by negative 3. So on the left side, I'll just get an x. Since I've divided by a negative number, I have to take this less than sign and make it into a greater than sign. In other words, it's going to be going the other way. It's changing direction. Now I can divide negative 6 by negative 3. That's going to just give me a 2. So my answer is going to be x is greater than 2. Even though I started with a negative sign in the original, because I divided by a negative number, I end up with a greater than sign over here. Showing this on the number line, here's my 0. Here is, let's say this is where the 2 is. X is not going to equal 2, so I'll put an open circle. X is greater than 2, so I want to darken the line everywhere where I've got a number bigger than 2. And I'll put my arrow in. And this is the way I'll display the answer on the number line. Now, one more kind of inequality we should talk about. This is kind of a neat one. Here I've got two inequality signs. I've got negative 6 is less than 4x plus 2 is less than, actually let's make that less than or equal to 12. We haven't done any or equal twos. Is less than or equal to 12. Now here's what we're going to do. I'm thinking if all I had was negative 6 is less than 4x plus 2, my first step would probably be to subtract 2 from both sides of this inequality sign. And if all I had was 4x plus 2 is less than or equal to 12, my first step would also be to subtract 2 from both sides of the inequality sign. So I'm just going to subtract 2 from everything. So now I've got negative 6 minus 2 is negative 8. I've got my less than sign. I've got a 4x. That's all I'll have in between the signs. I've got a less than or equal to sign. And I've got 12 minus 2 is 10. So once again, I'm thinking, if all I had was negative 8 is less than 4x, then what I would do would be to divide by 4, both here on the left and here where the 4x is. And if all I had was 4x is less than or equal to 10, I would also divide both sides of the inequality sign by 4. So I'm going to divide everything by 4. Okay, so I've got negative 8 over 4, that's the same as negative 2, is less than 4x over 4 is just x. I've got my less than or equal to sign, and 10 over 4 can be simplified into 5 over 2. So this is what my answer will be using the inequality symbols. If I have to show this on a number line, I'll draw my number line. Here's my 0. Here's negative 2 over here. Let's see. So I've got 5 halves. Let's realize that 5 halves is the same as 2.5. So if this is a 1, and this is a 2, and this is a 3, I guess my 5 halves will be right around here. Let's call that 2.5. And looking at this half, I know that negative 2 is less than x. It is not the same as x, so I want an open circle. When I deal with the 5 halves, I have a less than or equal to, so I'm going to put a closed in circle here. Now, the x is in between these two numbers. Okay? So, that means I want to darken all the area in between my two circles. So I'm darkening everything in between negative 2 and 2.5, or 2.5. So this line from negative 2, but not including the negative 2, that's why I have an open circle, all the way up to and including 2.5 is going to be the number line picture of this compound inequality. Did I say this is a compound inequality? If you have more than one inequality sign, it's called a compound inequality. And that's about it. Once again, the most important thing to remember is that if you multiply or divide by a negative, as I did over here, your inequality sign is going to change direction. Okay? That's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.